Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial Online Classes Real Analysis Infinite Series Class Number 3. In this class, we learn a theorem Cauchy Criteria for Convergence. Cauchy Criteria for Convergence of Infinite Series. The statement of this theorem is a series summation un is convergent if and only if for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to z plus such that mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 plus and so on plus uq less than epsilon for all q greater than or equals to p greater than or equals to m. Observe the statement. The infinite series summation un is convergent implies and implied by mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 plus and so on plus uq less than epsilon for all q greater than or equals to p greater than or equals to m. So let us prove this theorem. Let un be infinite series. Summation un be infinite series, Sn be the nth partial sum, Sn be the nth partial sum, take q greater than or equals to p, both q comma p belongs to positive integers, then sp is equals to sum of the first p terms, sp is equals to sum of the first p terms, sq is equals to sum of the first q terms, sp first p terms, sq first q terms, and q is greater than p, u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus up plus up plus 1 plus and so on plus uq. Now subtract them, sp minus sq, modulus of sp minus sq, you get, because of modulus it becomes positive, mod up plus 1 plus mod up plus 2 plus and so on plus mod uq. This is the introduction part of this theorem. Yes, now We prove the statement. Suppose summation un is convergent. An infinite series is convergent if and only if its nth partial sum is convergent. Therefore, Sn is convergent. We know that every convergent sequence is a Cauchy sequence. Therefore, Sn is a Cauchy sequence. A sequence is said to be Cauchy sequence if for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer m such that mod sp minus sq less than epsilon. Therefore, which is the definition of Cauchy sequence? Mod sp minus sq, already we find that mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 and so on plus uq, which is less than epsilon. Therefore, summation un is convergent implies and implied by for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to z plus such that mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 plus and so on plus uq less than epsilon. Observe that. Summation un is convergent. Infinite series is convergent means its nth partial sum Sn is convergent. Therefore, sequence Sn is convergent. Every convergent sequence is a Cauchy sequence. Therefore, Sn is a Cauchy sequence. Let us write the definition of Cauchy sequence. Every Cauchy sequence satisfies this condition mod sp minus sq less than epsilon. That mod sp minus sq is nothing but mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 plus and so on plus uq less than epsilon. Therefore, the infinite series summation un is convergent implies and implied by for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to z plus such that mod up plus 1 plus up plus 2 plus and so on plus uq less than epsilon for all q greater than or equals to p greater than or equals to m. This is known as Cauchy criteria for convergence of infinite series. There is a Cauchy criteria for convergence for sequences also. Already we explained that theorem in the chapter of sequences. Yes, this is in infinite series. Let us continue this class. We solve some problems depends upon the basic definitions and this theorem and also nth term test. The first problem is test for convergence. Summation n power n by n factorial. Test for convergence. Summation n power n by n factorial. n is equals to 1 to infinity. Let us try to solve this problem. Given series is summation n is equals to 1 to infinity n power n by n factorial. Here summation n is equals to 1 to infinity n power n by n factorial, which is equals to summation n is equals to 1 to infinity un. Here un is equals to n power n by n factorial. It can be written as n into and so on into n divided by 1 into 2 into 3 into and so on into n, which is equals to n by 1, n by 2, n by 3 and so on n by n, which is clearly greater than or equals to 1. Which is clearly greater than or equals to 1. You verify that. If you take n is equals to 2, you get un is equals to 2. It is clearly greater than or equals to 1. If un is clearly greater than or equals to 1 means, which implies limit n tends to infinity, un is not equals to 0. Limit n tends to infinity, un is not equals to 0. Limit n tends to infinity, un is not equals to 0. We know that if limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0, then summation un is not convergent. Summation un is not convergent. Observe that and try to understand the problem here by putting n is equals to 3. Suppose if you take n is equals to 3, then you get 3 by 1, 3 by 2, 3 by 3. 3 by 3 becomes 1, 3, 3, 9 by 2, 9 by 2 is 4.5. If you take n is equals to 3, then un is equals to 3 by 1, 3 by 2, 3 by 3, which is equals to 9 by 2, which is clearly greater than 1. Therefore, limit n tends to infinity, un not equals to 0. Therefore, summation un is not convergent. Let us solve the second problem. Test for convergence. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity, 1 by 4 power n. So given series is summation 1 by 4 power n. Here un is equals to 1 by 4 power n. Take Sn be the nth partial sum, Sn be the nth partial sum of summation un, means infinite series. Therefore, Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un, which is equals to 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 square plus and so on plus 1 by 4 power n. This is clearly a geometric progression. By using geometric progression formula, a into 1 minus r power n divided by 1 minus r, where a is initial term or first term, r is common ratio. Both the terms are equivalent to 1 by 4. Substitute them, we get a is equals to 1 by 4 into 1 minus 4 power n divided by 1 minus 1 by 4. 1 by 4 into 4 minus 1 by 4, you get 3 by 4, you get 4 by 3 into 1 minus 4 power n, which is equals to 4, 4 get cancelled, 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 into 4 power n, which is Sn. Now find its limit. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to limit n tends to infinity 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 into 4 power n, which is equals to 1 by 3 minus 0 is equals to 1 by 3. Therefore, limit n tends to infinity Sn is equals to 1 by 3, which implies this is a finite constant. 1 by 3 is a finite constant. Therefore, Sn converges to 1 by 3. It means nth partial sum converges to 1 by 3. Therefore, the infinite series 1 by 4 power n is convergent, to 1 by 3. Let us remember the definition. An infinite series is convergent if its nth partial sum is convergent. An infinite series is divergent if its nth partial sum is divergent. Yes, observe that. Let us see the next problem. Prove that summation 1 by n square is divergent. Test for convergence. Summation 1 by n square. Limit n tends to infinity, n square. Here un is equals to n square. Let Sn be the nth partial sum of summation un. Then Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un. Now, because of un is equals to n square, u1 is equals to 1 square, u2 is equals to 2 square and so on plus n square. The sum of the first nH, the sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers, n into the sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers, n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to limit n tends to infinity, n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6, which tends to infinity. Therefore, the sequence Sn is divergent. If the nth partial sum is divergent, therefore, the infinite series summation n square is also divergent. Observe that. If you want to take a screenshot now, you can take it now. And discuss the convergence or divergence of the infinite series. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity log of 1 plus 1 by n. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity log of 1 plus 1 by n. Un is equals to log of 1 plus 1 by n. Take nth partial sum Sn. Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un. Log of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus log of 1 plus 1 by 2 plus log of 1 plus 1 by 3 plus and so on plus log of 1 plus 1 by n. Log 2 plus log of 3 by 2 plus log of 2, 4 by 3 plus and so on plus log of n plus 1 by n. Again, it can be written as log 2 plus log 3 minus log 2 plus log 4 minus log 3 plus and so on plus log of n plus 1 minus log n. I think every term will be cancelled. We get only log of n plus 1. We get only the last but one term. Log of n plus 1. Let us find the limit. Limit n tends to infinity. Sn is equals to. Limit n tends to infinity. Log of n plus 1. Clearly it tends to infinity. Sn tends to infinity means Sn is divergent. Sn is divergent means summation log of the infinite series summation log of 1 plus 1 by n is also divergent. Let us solve the next problem. Discuss the convergence of the series summation square root of n by square root of n by 2 into n plus 1. square root of n by 2 into n plus 1. Here un is equals to square root of n into square root of n by 2 into n plus 1, which is equals to 1 by root 2 into root n by square root of n plus 1, 1 by root 2 into root n by root n into root of 1 plus 1 by n, 1 by root 2 into 1 by square root of 1 plus 1 by n. Let us find its limit. Limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to limit n tends to infinity, sorry, limit n tends to infinity, 1 by root 2 into 1 by square root of 1 plus 1 by n, 1 by root 2. Therefore, limit n tends to infinity, un not equals to 0, which implies summation un is divergent. Summation un is divergent. Observe that. Next problem, find the nature of the series summation n is equals to 1 to infinity 1 by n into n plus 1. 1 by n into n plus 1. Find the nature of the infinite series summation n is equals to 1 to infinity 1 by n into n plus 1. You observe that here one by n into n plus 1 is equals to summation un. Un is equals to 1 by n into n plus 1. You can write it as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Let us take Sn be the nth partial sum. Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un, which is equals to 1 by n minus, which is equals to 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus and so on plus 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Every term get cancelled, we get 1 by 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to. Limit n tends to infinity, 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. As n tends to infinity, we get 1 minus 0, 1. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to 1. It means the sequence Sn is convergent to 1. We know that an infinite series is convergent if its nth partial sum is convergent. Therefore, summation un is also convergent to 1. That is, summation 1 by n into n plus 1 is convergent to the limit n is equals to 1. Now verify the convergence of the following series. Practice some problems. Try yourself. Test for convergence. Try yourself. The first one. Summation 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. Answer is divergent. Second one. Summation 1 by root n plus 1 plus root n. This is also divergent. Third one. Summation 1 by n plus 1 into n plus 2. This is convergent. Summation. Fourth one. Cos of 1 by n. Test for convergence. This series also divergent. Try yourself. Try to verify the convergence of this series. I give the answers also. These first two series are divergent. Third one is convergent and fourth one is again divergent. practice these problems according to the definition.